Looking back now, I think we had a unique sound, we still do. It's a blueprint and it's like a brand sound. And not many bands can say that they created something pretty new. Seventh floor, brewing alternatives. What's in the bottom drawer? Waiting for things to give. Spare us the cat eye. I remember around the time of Crocodile thinking we're the biggest band in the world or the best, you know. So it wasn't a surprise so much. Looking back now, yeah, I can see the, you know, debut album going in top 20 is a big deal. Ian Curtis from Joy Division had died and stuff, so we were kind of the trailblazers for a certain dark rock thing. You know, and in those days, the early, you know, you look at early photos of anyone, it's like, that is the best looking group in the world, you know? And everything looks like the camouflage, the coats, and we didn't give a crap about what we said either. I mean, that was the main thing, the attitude was just like, couldn't give a sudden crap. You don't want that bad. Gotta talk, gotta see us creep, crawl. I know you know, you know I know.
I don't think we fit in. We've never wanted to fit in. It's not what a punk rocker would want to do, is fit in, you know.
Well, now boy bands have punk hairdos, you know. And in those days, it was like you could get your head kicked in for looking that way. You know, there were punks in London who were getting battered all the time, you know, just for looking a bit different. Porcupines are kind of, it's like the Ringo, the sore thumb of those first four albums. It's kind of, people find it easier to say they like Crocodiles, Heaven Up Here or Ocean Rain. Porcupine, because it's bristly and spiky.
We got to the point where we'd say doing about 10,000 people in America, and we could probably pull that off. And that's when Mac left, when we were like at our sort of the height. So it was just downhill after that, really. Yeah.
But I thought we'd lost the plot, maybe. I wasn't getting on with the other three. More than that, it just felt like all the great thing about the Bunnymen had been lost somewhere. With the comeback, it was more Echo and the Bunnymen than it was in that last year or so.
Nothing ever lasts forever.
And I knew it was like the big song that we needed to launch the comeback. You know, Nothing Lasts Forever was a classic Bunnymen song, and I wrote it. I'd written it years before, but for some reason I must have saved it for that rainy day.
Don't tell me that my ship is coming in. Nothing comes to those who wait. Time's running out the door, you're running in. So I want more than I can get. Just trying to forget. Nothing ever lasts forever. Nothing ever lasts forever.
Almost like an anthem on Radio 1 or something, you know. We were always on TFI Friday with Chris Evans and stuff. It was quite a good time. It was like the best comeback ever and all that sort of nonsense in the papers.
Writing for Echo and the Bunnymen gives me a different... It's just a different thing. It's like being told who you are, you know, this is your character, and go and play. And I hadn't realised how much that means, you know. It's like being a football supporter of a team. You can't suddenly be, you know, a Chelsea fan. You should never be one of them.
Buried alive.
Yeah, it was kind of a time in my life where I thought, how old you live to these days, if you're lucky, 80. I was maybe about 40, half the way home. Yeah. About dying, I suppose. Place where Russia, bad Russia, sent all the people with heat, all the kind of stuff that they couldn't handle, the passion and the dissidents. They got sent to Siberia to try and freeze them out, and it didn't work. And that's kind of where I always think the Bunnymen stand. You know, it's like a band there. Doesn't belong in the main part of rock and roll or whatever. Basically me trying to say I'm ready to dream again and to believe in something again and to be happy, I think.
Help me believe how I used to believe. Now do you see how there in the margins below and up above.
Stormy Weather's great. It's kind of when I think it's about me more than anything, but initially to explain to myself the opening line, hope you're feeling better now, hope you got my letter, how is my stormy weather now, is she gonna change? I imagined a woman who was a lunatic, who was locked up in a padded cell.
Stormy weather now, is she gonna change?
stole me weather, that's how I feel I am. I think if you could describe me, it would be stormy weather.
Yeah, it's been good. It's like, you know, me and him can just sit down with two guitars and a drum machine ticking away, and it just sounds like it was in, you know, my dad's back room in 1978. You know, it still sounds the same, still kind of primitive, and we're still trying to sound like the Velvet Underground. To shine this night, you want
it, you got it. We always said in the beginning, you know, we're not interested in big yachts and stuff. I wouldn't mind a yacht still, but it was always, we wanted to be a band that were recognised as inspirational and influential.
27 years, it's been strange because it seems like 27 minutes, you know, it's just gone like that.